You are actually one of the only openly gay celebrities in Korea. 그치?
아,
거의
네, 맞아.
거의 오빠밖에 없는 거잖아 지금 한국에서.
희한해. 내가 coming out 한 지 20년 됐거든.
God, it's been 20 years since
yeah,
you came out.
2000s I came out.
And you did that on TV?
Yeah, on TV. And on magazine too.
So how was it? Because you're basically the Ellen of Korea. 오빠가 엘렌 디제너러스랑 똑같은 사람이야 거의.
맞죠, 맞죠.
Because Ellen came out on TV on her show,
yeah.
In like a episode of her show Ellen, and then she did an interview with Diane Sawyer and went through that whole process. 그러니까 오빠가 진짜 거의 비슷한 똑같은 이미지야 그분이랑.
그치. 근데 이제 엘렌은 huge celebrity고 나는.
No, everyone knows. Everybody knows you here. 어디에 가도 오빠 모르는 사람은 없어.
한국만.
He walks around anywhere, and everyone will notice him. First of all, because he's bald.
Yeah.
Second of all, he is so tall.
Yeah.
And he's just got this positive energy that is following him everywhere he goes. But tell me about that. 20년 전에 TV에서 내가 아마 대학생 때였을 거야. 그때 아마 막 졸업했을 텐데.
너 마흔 가까이 됐어?
I'm 33. 한국 나이로.
34.
Yeah, 나 생각보다 나이 많아. Yeah. I'm older than a lot of people think.
20s 줄 알았어.
No, I'm in my 30s. I'm heading up there. But I remember seeing the clip. I remember it. And I remember it being very emotional for you. 그치?
Right.
어떻게 그 거기까지 오빠가 결정을 한 거야? How did you come to that decision to do that?
사실은 이제 내가 게이라는 거는 내가 좀 어렸을 때부터 좀 느꼈고.
Right. So he knew since he was younger that he knew. How old do you think you were when you were like I know that?
10.
When you were 10. That's very young age to realize and accept that.
Yeah, I realize I'm quite different than other boys.
Right. So.
그러고 나서 내가 20 됐을 때 서울에 와서 이제 대학교를 다녔는데 그때부터 이제 나와 비슷한 사람들이 어디에 있는지 굉장히 궁금해서 사람들 만나고 얘기하고 싶고.
So in his 20s, he came back to Korea. Where did you go to school?
No, no, Seoul University.
Oh, Seoul University.
저기 한양 University.
Oh, 한양 University. So in his 20s, when he was going to university, he started getting more curious about other people that were like him and yeah. wondering where they were.
Because I had no information about gay scene in Korea, and
right
at that moment, and we only have place to meet the people in Jongno area.
Jongno area, right. That was the gay area
back
in the day, right?
I
do remember hearing about that.
So I always walk around Tapgol Park. I read one magazine like Sunday Seoul something like that. You know Sunday Seoul?
No, I don't know what that is. What is that?
That's a magazine.
It's Korean magazine.
Yeah, Korean magazine, but it's like a tabloid magazine.
Oh, I see. And it said
and
area.
Yeah. Something like.
Oh,
this.
Oh, wow, interesting.
Yeah. So that's why I visited the park and just walk around. So whenever I met, I saw the boys, and like, oh my god, maybe he might be gay. How can I start to talk with that guy? Something like that. So.
Yeah. And then, so how then, did you become an actor?
대학교 졸업하고, after I
graduated.
School. And 그러고 나서 이제, I did a sitcom. Like a 남자셋 여자셋.
Yeah, three girls, three boys. It's like friends.
Right. Yeah. So
you did you audition for it and get in?
No.
Or you got scouted?
Yeah,
or?
They just chose me.
Oh, they scouted you. Were you just walking on the street?
No. 나는 그 전에 이제 뮤지컬 하고 연극 하고 CF 모델 하고 그리고 여러 가지 이제 에피소드 드라마 조금씩 했는데 이제 감독님이 나한테 굉장히 스몰 파트를 줬는데 그걸 너무 재밌게 해서 이 파트가 되게 롤이 커졌어.
Right.
그래서 되게 유명해졌는데 그러니까 유명해지니까 뭐 돈도 많이 벌고 뭐 유명해지고 다 좋은데 나의 그 개인적인 프라이빗 라이프는 없어진 거지. 근데 그때 내가 남자친구가 있었어.
Oh, really? All right, let me update y'all in English what he's been saying. So he had been doing musicals and plays like that throughout college and doing CFs here and there as a model. And a director picked him up. And what would the English title of that direct translation? It's Three Girls and Three Boys, basically. Yes, so it's the same format as Friends, Korean version of Friends. And normally his role was very small, but he did such an excellent job that the director made his role bigger. And it became one of a very iconic roles that really kind of, I guess, kickstarted his career as an actor. But the fame was there and the money was there, but his personal life started dwindling. And at the time, he had a boyfriend.
Yeah.
Am I good at translating or what? I'm good. Okay, keep going.
어, 내 영어 선생님 했으면 좋겠다. 대박 잘해. 아, 진짜.
All right, so
그래서 아, 원래 이제 그 외국 분들은 이제 송승헌, 소지섭 다 아실 건데 한류 스타니까
yeah.
이제 그 친구들이 신인 때 나랑 같이 한 거야.
아, so 그 송, 프렌즈가. 송승헌 And Sojisop, they were on the show.
Superstars.
Were they on that show with
yeah.
you? Yeah, so they were on that show together. So they basically started the career together.
Yeah,
okay.
Right. Mm-hmm. And 그래서 그때 내 남자친구가 Dutch였어.
Your first boyfriend?
Yeah.
Your first boyfriend was Dutch?
Yeah.
He was a foreigner? Oh,
okay. 왜냐면 유명해지기 전에는 uh-huh. 한국 남자친구가 잠깐 있었는데 uh-huh. 이제 좀 길게 만난 남자친구는 아~ 그 더치 보이프렌드가 처음인데
어허.
그 친구한테 이제 굉장히 많은 영향을 받았지.
Yeah.
그 전까지는 내가 게이인 걸 숨기려고 하고 게이인 걸 부끄러워하고
yeah.
뭐 어디 가서는 막 그냥 스트레이트인 mm-hmm. 척하고 이랬는데
mm-hmm.
이제 아무래도 right. 네덜란드 친구가 mm-hmm. 어, 넌 너무 아름다운 사람이다.
Uh-huh.
네가 게이지만 너무 아름다운 사람이고 너무 사랑받을 수 있는 사람이다. 이런 얘기를 yeah. 너무 많이 해서
oh.
내가 좀 당당해져야 될 필요가 있겠다.
Yeah.
그런 생각을 했지.
So when he was younger, he had met Korean guys here and there, but for a long-term, real serious relationship for the first time was with this guy from the Netherlands.
Yeah.
And because, you know, foreigners are a lot more able to express their feelings and express everything about them without being quite judged. So it influenced Tony a lot because he would say things like, you're beautiful, you're gay, but you're beautiful and you're a great person. And that really made him want to be strong and take a stance on who he is and embrace all of himself.
Mm-mm.
That's great. Do you?
Yeah. I mean, like a beautiful. 이거 아니고.
No. Beautiful, yeah, your 이거. Your heart. Yeah, yeah. No, but you can look.
Yeah.
You can look it. You no. can look it.
이것도 이렇게 beautiful이라고 넌 얘기를 해야지.
It is. 나 지금 얘기하고 있는 거야.
그래.
I said you're beautiful.
그걸 먼저 얘기했어야지. 삐질 뻔했잖아.
No, no, you okay, beautiful okay. inside and out. Yes.
You beautiful.
Thank you.
그래서 그런 이제 자신 나를 이렇게 스스로 인정하고 받아들이는 게이로서 나를 인정하는 게 제일 어려운 건데.
Yeah.
내가 게이라는 거를 스스로 받아들이고 아, 게이로서 행복하게 살려면 어떻게 해야 될까?
Yeah.
이런 고민을 했는데 그때 이제 나는 뭐 네덜란드도 가보고 뭐 뭐 뉴욕도 가보고 뭐 LA도 가보고 이렇게 전 세계를 좀 많이 다녀보니까 게이 친구들을 보고 얘기를 하다 보니까 굉장히 그거에 대한 인플루언스가 되게 많았어요. 인플루언스가. 그래서 아 내가 한국에서 앞으로도 계속 행복하게 게이로서 살려면 유명해지는 것도 중요한데 사실은 솔직하게 사는 게 더 중요하겠다라는 생각을 해서 서른 살 때 그때가 밀레니엄이었거든.
Right, 2000년도가. Yeah.
그래서 새로운 세계가 다 변하는 그런 시기여서
yeah.
아, 내가 뭐 게이지만 커밍아웃을 해도 시간이 조금 걸리겠지만 좀 받아들여줄 수 있는 사람이 있지 않을까?
Mm-hmm.
이런 생각을 하고 이제 커밍아웃을 했지.
So
after I broke up with the Dutch
wait, wait, wait. Okay, let's track back. So being gay, the first thing that needs to happen is you accepting yourself for that, you know, and once he did that, he traveled the world a bit, going to Netherlands, New York, LA, and meeting more other people like him who had influenced him in a positive way. And he soon realized that it doesn't really matter about being famous. It's being true to who you are.
Yeah.
And and not being afraid to express that. And so in 2000, in the millennium, it was the perfect timing almost, right? Yes, yeah. For these changes and also for change for myself inside to happen. So that's when you decided you're going to let the world know.
Yeah, I knew if I came out on TV, on public, I'm going to lose everything, all right. my fame, something like this. Mm-hmm. But even if that, I'm still 30.
Yes.
So I'm still young.
Yeah.
And I thought like I could start again.
Yeah.
Everything, anything actually.
Yeah.
So that's why I make decision to
That's a very, I'm so proud of you that you did that.
Yeah.
I think that was one of the best things you could have ever done in your life.
Yeah.
And you had to basically stay away from TV for a long time after that, right?
Almost three and a half years.
Three and a half years. You were nothing on TV, nothing on radio, nothing public at all. How was that response when you finally came out on TV? What outlet was that? Was that like on a news or on the platform 나왔던 거지? 그 방송이?
그거? 그거 인터뷰가 그냥 너무 많이 나와가지고 원래 기자들이 그때 내가 외국 갔다가 들어올 때 공항에서 다 기자들이 기다렸었거든.
Oh, the
내가 매거진에서 coming out 한 게 소문이 나서
The paparazzi was waiting for him at the airport because he came out on an interview in a magazine. First.
Yeah.
Okay.
So 그래서 그때 이제 내가 다시 필름을 만들었어. 비디오 테이프.
Mm-hmm. By yourself?
With a producer, my friends 해서 캐스션하고 내가 연습하고 해가지고 그걸 다 돌렸지.
To the paparazzi.
Yeah, to the
everyone.
No paparazzi. Media.
To the media.
Yeah, to the media.
오빠가 직접 다 보낸 거야 그거.
아니 우리 감독님이.
감독님이. So you made that video that I saw. Then basically.
Yeah.
그 영상을 오빠가 직접 찍어서.
Yeah, my producer가 그 남자세 여자세 producer가 그걸 만들어 주셨어.
Oh, so the.
왜냐면 그 gay 이슈가 너무 큰 이슈여서 이렇게 기자회견을 할 수 있었는데 너무 막 질문이나 이런 게 좀 이상한 질문이 올까 봐 그 질문을 다 만들어서 테이프를 만들었죠.
Okay, so it was pre-recorded. The producer of Three Girls and Three Boys at the time put that together. And instead of having everyone come and do like a press release because they were worried that people were going to ask unnecessary or rude or just mean questions, they had the interview questions all written out and basically did this and then spread it to the media so they could write articles about it.
Yes.
And obviously the response was more negative, right, than positive. 반응이 그 당시에는
negative지.
Was it? You would say all of it was basically negative at the time.
Yeah, like a 99%.
99%. Yeah.